Good morning, students. Now I am going to discuss nerve base classifier. So now, what is nerve base classifier? The nerve base classifier applies to learn task where each instant x is described by conjunction of attribute values, and where the target function. Already we indicated target function f of x can take on any value from some finite set V, and also we can define as a set of training example of the target function f of x is provided, and also a new instance is presented described by the tuple of attribute values. We can consider as a1 a2 and so on. Based on the problem, we can consider the attributes a1 a2 and so on am. And also there are learner is asked to predict the target value. Based on the target value, we are going to classify for this new instance. So this is nothing but what is nerve base classifier. Now we will see in depth. So the Bayesian approach, already in the previous lecture we discussed Bayesian approach to classify the new instances is to assign the most probable target value. That is nothing but a Vmap given that can be given in the attribute values a1 a2 and so on am, and that can be described in the instance. So we can describe Vmap is equal to org max of vz epsilon v and p of vz bar a1 a2 a3 and so on an, that attributes. Use the Bayes theorem to rewrite this expression. By using the Bayes theorem, we can rewrite this expression. So Vmap is nothing but augment of Vz is epsilon V. So we can write it as we know the probable Bayesian classification. So P of A1, A2 and so attributes slash Vz of P of Vz divided by that P of probability of attributes. That is nothing P of A1, A2 and so on An. So here, the probability of attributes is nothing but a 1. So we can rewrite this one. So argument of P, the denominator value, probability of attributes is nothing but a 1. So this is, we can consider this is the equation number 1. From the Bayes classifier is based on the assumptions that the attribute values are conditionally independent that can be given in the target value. And also mean the assumption is that given the target values of the instant, and also probability of the observing the conjunction of a1 a2 a3 and so on am is the just the product of the probability of the individual attributes. So that we can rewrite this one, probability of a1 a2 and so on an var vz is nothing but a product of p of ai divided by vz. Okay, so we can substitute this value in the previous base classifier. So V and B is nothing but augment of Vz epsilon V. So P of Vz into this P of VA A1 A2 slash Vz, we can substitute as product of I into P of AI divided by Vz. That we can consider as a equation number 2. Here V and B is nothing but a target value output from the base classifier. Okay, now this can be explained with the example. So let us consider one example. Let us apply this nerve base classifier to the concept learning problem. So already in the concept learning problem we consider some 14 training examples, whether the person is played tennis or not. Same example we can consider here, and we can use this base classifier, and how to classify we will see now. Classifying days according to whether someone will play tennis or not. So the below example, we am going to consider the 14 training examples of the target concept, whether the person is played tennis or what are the possibilities. So for that I am going to consider the four attributes. The four attributes are: first one is outlook, second one is temperature, third one is humidity and wind. Now you can see already same example we consider here in the module 1 concept learning. Same thing, same example I am considering. So here we are going to consider our outcome is nothing but play tennis or not. So that is nothing but yes or no. Use the nerve base classifier and training the data from this table to classify the following novel instance. That is nothing but outlook is nothing but so we are going to consider outlook is nothing but outlook is sunny outlook is sunny and temperature is nothing but a cool and humidity is high and wind is nothing but a strong. So our task is to predict the target value SR. So target is nothing but either S or no of the target concept from the play whether the person is played tennis or not. So VNB is nothing but we already got it, argmax of VJ of so epsilon 2. So we are going to output outcome is nothing but S or no P of VJ, P of VJ into product of P of AI divided by VJ, correct? Now I am going to consider this product of AI, though attributes is nothing but 4 attributes in that output outlook. So first one is first attribute outlook is equal to sunny VJ in that temperature. Next attribute is another probability of temperature is equal to cool. Next to humidity is equal to high. Next attribute is wind is equal to strong. So we have to find out attributes of these 4. Now from the probability of different target values can easily be estimated based on the frequency over the 14 training example. Now I'm going to consider probability of played tennis is equal to, so out of 14, so played tennis is S only 9, so probability of played tennis S is 9/14, so we'll get 0.64. same thing, probability of played tennis is equal to no, that is nothing but a 5 divided by 14 is 0.36. similarly, estimate the condition probability. So we are going to consider only each, this is nothing but a total attributes. I am going to consider the each individual attribute. For example, wind is equal to strong. So now you see wind is equal to, so in the table wind is equal to strong. So wherever wind is equal to strong, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in that thing. So consider the separately wind is equal to strong versus whether the play tennis or not. Strong wind is equal to strong is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and also that corresponding S or no, where the play tennis S or no. So based on that I'm going to classify probability of wind is equal to strong whether play tennis is S. So total 9, so in that 3 only play tennis is S in that category, so 0.33. and then wind is equal to strong, play tennis is equal to no, play tennis is equal to no, wind is equal to strong but play tennis is no, that is 3/5. So that equation is 0.6. so from that by using this one I'm going to calculate VNB. So VNB is nothing but a P probability of S, probability of sunny is S, probability of cool is S, probability of high S, probability of strong S. So that is nothing but a 0.00 based on this one, 0.0053. same thing we can do for the others also, 0.0206. now by using the Naive's classifier, the target value play tennis is equal to no, to this instant based on the probability estimation learned from the training data, by normalize the above quantity, the sum to be 1, and also calculate the conditional probability, the target value is nothing but you know, by observing the attribute values. Now I'm going to conclude this one. So zero, but the total is 0.0206 no divided by total sum of, that is nothing but 0.0206 plus 0.0053. so we'll get, this is play tennis no probability, so 0.795. okay, now we'll see estimating probability. So estimating probability is nothing but we have estimated the probability by the fraction of times that event is observed to occur over the total number of opportunities. Based on this we have calculated estimated probability. Now for example, in the above example, estimated probability P of wind is equal to strong slash play tennis is equal to no by the fraction where n is nothing but a, n is nothing but total n, negative is nothing but a 5, the total number of training example for which the play tennis is nothing but is equal to no, nc is nothing but a c. So the number of these for which wind is equal to strong is nc. When nc is equal to 0, then nc slash n will be the 0, and also this probability term will be dominated the quality calculated, and also it can be calculated using the second equation, and it required to multiply all the probability terms by this zero values. To avoid this difficulty, we can adopt a Bayesian approach to estimate that probability using the M estimated, described as follows. So So that estimated m estimated probability is nothing but nc plus mp positive divided by n plus m. N is nothing but a negative plus m total. So p is our priority estimation of the probability we wish to determine, and also m is nothing but a constant called the equivalent sample size, which determines how heavy to determine the positive related to the observed data, and p is the absence of their information to assume the uniform priority. If the attribute has k possible values, we will set p is nothing but a 1 by k. Okay, remaining topics we'll see in the next class.